another organ, the gut, because it's another very area of interest of mine. And you recently published that the gut microbiome, so we'll quickly go through this, the gut microbiome is also, well, bacteria are living organisms, and they are also on a circadian rhythm.
Yeah.
And what I found very interesting from some of your recent work is that you showed that different bacterial species within the gut, at least in a mouse, also seem to, you seem to have more of these species during certain times of the day and less during certain times of the day. And this was different in obese animals versus, you know, non-obese animals. Or that is very fascinating. Can you explain that just?
Yeah, so bacteria, they just like us, they need their own niche. They need their own pH, temperature, nutrition, and all these factors. And now you can imagine that when we eat, we kind of change the gut environment, the content of the gut slightly, so that some bacteria may find it easier to grow, and then some other bacteria may find it very difficult to grow in that condition. So what happens is when we eat in a time-restricted fashion, we have a very fixed eating and fasting interval, then during eating, that environment will promote a certain set of bacteria to bloom, and then the other bacteria kind of become quiescent, quiet. And then after a few hours of fasting, then the second set of bacteria will bloom. So in that way, what it helps is, it helps to nurture different, a wide variety of species to cohabit in our gut. And they also function at different time of the day, during the daytime. So for example, when you're eating, we need a lot of bacteria to break down starch and fibers, complex carbohydrates, and also conjugate some bile acids and et cetera. So we need different players to do different things throughout day and night. And by time-restricted feeding, this alternating two different types of environment, one where there is a lot of food and the pH is very different versus one when there is fasting, there is scarcity of food and the pH is very different. By alternating between these two different environments, we promote this diversity inside the gut. And why this is important is we actually don't understand why, but research from a very different field, from gut microbiome field, they are now finding is it's much better to have a more diverse microbiome in your gut than to have only one or two very simple species. So in some way, by having the time-restricted feeding, it promotes their diversity. There are a few interesting things that we found, which we are still working on to figure out why it happens. For example, mice that had time-restricted feeding, although the bacteria could break down the complex carbohydrate to simple carbohydrate, for some reason that simple carbohydrate could not be taken up by the gut. It actually went out in the poop. And that was a surprise because usually simple carbohydrates are the ones that get absorbed. So we think that this compositional change somehow protects the complex carbohydrate in the upper intestine. So it comes back to the lower intestine where it gets degraded. But we know that the lower intestine doesn't absorb sugar. It's only in the upper intestine. So in that way, by this compositional change, we can completely shift how nutrition is even absorbed into the gut. The other thing that we also found is bile acids, which are very emerging as very important players in health. Those bile acids are also better managed with time-restricted feeding, both in the liver and also in the gut. Bile acids are made in liver and then they cycle back and forth between gut and liver. And bile acids are made from cholesterol. So there is an enzyme in liver that gets upregulated in time-restricted feeding. And that enzyme breaks down cholesterol to bile. So you get dual benefit. You reduce cholesterol, increase bile acid. And that bile acid comes to the gut and it helps absorb some fat back into the gut. And then it gets conjugated by this bacteria. And for some reason, we don't understand, in time-restricted feeding, they get modified in a different way than in normal feeding. So these are some of the new research directions we're taking. We're trying to understand how this gut microbiome interacts with timing of food and then changes their changes the compositional aspect of the gut.
It's very interesting.